Okay, so yesterday was Google I/O's keynote as I'm recording this. And there are a number of key things that they talked about. There are a lot of products that they showed. I kind of feel that they probably showed a little bit too much and didn't really sell some of them as well as they could have. But they're really trying to cram a lot in there to show what a lot of people have been working on. And there are clearly lots and lots of LLM projects, AI projects that are happening inside Google, where they're trying to build products for end consumers, as well as being able to empower developers to do some of these things. So what I'm planning is actually to do three videos around this. This first video, I'm going to talk about all the sort of updates around Gemini and look at what's going on with Gemini. In the second video, I'm going to look at agents and what actually is going on with agents at Google, and how that some of the things that are announced at the I/O keynote are actually quite different than the cloud next stuff that they did with agents. And also some of the thinking of where they're going with agents as well. And then in the third video, I'll look at more sort of things around the developer tools, around the new Gemma models, around some of the interesting things that they announced for Firebase for generative AI. So if you're building apps with JavaScript and stuff like that, they've got some new things out there that are interesting as well. So let's get started with jumping in and having a look at Gemini here. So first off, let's start off by looking at the whole idea of the Gemini era. It's a year since Google basically announced they were working on Gemini, and obviously the models first came out in December last year. Since then, we've seen them really start to accelerate with those kind of updates and stuff like that. We saw the whole Gemini 1.5 come in February this year. And a lot of what they talked about reinforced these kind of things. Google basically says that 1.5 million developers are using Gemini now, which does fit with some of the industry surveys that people have been doing and stuff like that recently for this. Google themselves have put Gemini into pretty much every product that they've got, right? So they showed basically a slide that they're using Gemini and everything from sort of Gmail to Google Play, to Chrome, etc. And they've actually integrated it in all 2 billion user products, meaning that over 2 billion users are actually using Gemini without actually knowing this. They do have the Gemini app, and I think that's only available in some countries and stuff like that. Obviously, being in the United States at the moment, I'm seeing like, okay, what's actually available here compared to what's not available overseas. Although I do get the feeling that Google is definitely intentionally trying to roll these things out across the world as they go along. One of the interesting stats that they mentioned was that Gemini Advanced already has over 1 million users. So this is their paid version of the product. One of the things that's interesting with the Gemini Advanced is they're actually updating that now to use the Gemini 1.5 Pro model with 1 million contexts. That means that you're going to be able to do a lot of cool things with that that you just couldn't do before. They're also incorporating a lot of new things so that you can basically upload your own documents and use them in the context quite easily. This is something that's new and that wasn't available before with that sort of paid service. So I guess the general trend is that the Gemini 1.5 Pro model is becoming the sort of workhorse model with this 1 million context, which is kind of amazing to think that like only a few months ago, people would have thought this was impossible. And then beyond this, they actually announced that they're now going to make the Gemini 1.5 Pro model for developers be able to go out to 2 million tokens for the context window. Personally, I'm not sure how much 2 million is better than 1 million. I guess it's double. But it is interesting to see that this shows clearly that Google's now starting to work out some of the key problems that they were having around compute, around serving these models, and they are now starting to be able to scale these up. We saw that the Gemini 1.5 Pro with 1 million contexts is now in Gemini Advanced. It's now going to be in a thing called NotebookLM. So if you see here, now when you log into NotebookLM, you will see that it's got Gemini 1.5 Pro in here. Interesting, they also hinted that they're actually working on going for infinite context window. And in a conversation that I was in with Jeff Dean and some other people later on in the day, it clearly seemed that the idea of having this infinite context window is something that they're working a lot on when people were asking, or could we put the entire internet into a context window and stuff like that. So it does seem there's a lot of interesting ideas going on around the whole idea of long context window models and stuff like that. It does seem that they're not doing it in a traditional way. I won't go into too many details, but clearly they're not using quadratic attention to do this. They're working on other ways of doing this. And there have been a number of papers recently from Google that have talked about some of those things. They also launched yesterday a new version of Gemini 1.5 Pro. So this is an updated version that they're actually seeing does better on quite a number of different tasks compared to the original model that came out. So I think if you're using this in AI Studio now, you will basically have access to the latest one. Certainly if you're using it in the consumer products like Gemini Advanced, NotebookLM, these things are now getting this latest Gemini Pro 1.5 model in there. Okay, so another interesting Gemini feature that they announced was the whole idea of this context caching for Google Gemini. So what this basically means is currently you've got the Gemini Pro 1.5 model can have a context of up to 1 million tokens. Now, if you use sort of anything above 128,000, you're going to be billed at $7 per million tokens. But anything under 128,000 will be billed at $3.50 per million tokens. So if your prompts are not that long, you can basically get away with it. Now, the idea of context caching, though, actually is interesting. And what it does is it allows you to basically upload, say, 600, 800,000 tokens. Perhaps you've got a video, some audio, something like that. And you want to ask multiple questions of it. What you can then do is basically run it through, pay for your tokens, and then cache those tokens for $4, I think it's something like $4.50 for an extra hour to keep that context warm. And then every query that you do with those tokens, you don't actually get charged again for those tokens. You just get charged for what you add to it. So if you had a context of 800,000 tokens, you ask a question or a few questions or something of 1,000 tokens on top of that, you run that through, you're going to basically be able to cache those 800,000 tokens and reuse them again without having to pay for it again and again. You just pay for it the first time and you can pay a cost for, you know, keeping those tokens in there. So this is something that definitely will allow people to sort of stuff big amounts of tokens that they use for certain prompts and stuff in here. And it really reinforces the whole idea that Google's going for is an infinite context window in here. So that was something that was, so already they've announced the availability of the 2 million. My guess is that we're probably not that far away from getting even more than that going forward in the future. And finally, for the sort of consumer things, they've actually now put Gemini 1.5 Pro into all the Workspace labs and stuff like that. You should see that their Docs products, their Slides products, their Sheets products should get quite a nice boost using this new model that they've got there. For developers, on top of the ability to keep context between calls, so that while the model can now go out to 2 million tokens, if your call is actually just like 30,000 tokens or something, it's actually going to end up being a lot cheaper for this. So the big things that they did stress about the whole sort of Gemini models is around the two main things, around the multimodality and around the long context windows in here. And the final Gemini news, they introduced the whole Gemini 1.5 Flash model. So personally, I don't think they did a great job of selling this model. I've actually been one of the people testing this model. And the whole idea with the Gemini 1.5 Flash model is that one of the things is that this is a whole lot cheaper than the Gemini 1.5 Pro. Obviously, it's a smaller version of the model that still runs in the cloud. And in many ways, you could think of this as Google's Haiku model. So you've probably seen me make a lot of videos about Haiku and the advantages of this, of having a small model that is still high quality, but is one, very quick, and two, very cheap in here. And this is what Gemini 1.5 Flash is for Google. So they talk about this as being all about speed and efficiency with this model. But really, I would say it's three things. You've got like the speed and efficiency as one element. You've got the multimodal being a key element there too. But just having a lower cost model as well is one of the key things to think about with this. So the cost for 1 million tokens in for this is 35 cents, as opposed to the much more expensive versions of Gemini 1.5 Pro. And even that now has gotten cheaper with the version where if you're sending less than 128,000 tokens, the price actually comes down quite a bit in here. But I think Flash is going to be a really good model for a lot of people where they want something that they can just get good results back. Maybe it's not going to be as intelligent as the 1.5 Pro or the Ultra model. There was not a lot of talk about around the Ultra model, which kind of surprised me yesterday. But I think we'll see some things in the near future around that. But the 1.5 Flash really opens up a number of different things. And I will make some videos about this with code and stuff going forward of what it can do and how you can do it and some of those kinds of things around it. One of the great things is that both 1.5 Pro now and 1.5 Flash are available to people in Google AI Studio and in Vertex AI. So you can go in and test these things out straight away. And the cool thing with the AI Studio is you can actually try some prompts out and see the different results you get for Flash versus what you get for the bigger 1.5 Pro model in there. Okay, so hopefully this video has gotten you up to date on what's going on with Google's Gemini models. Like I said, I'm going to have another video about Google Agents, and I'm also going to have another video around Gemma and some of the interesting things around training those. I guess the big takeaways for Gemini is that Google is really doubling down on the 1.5 Pro model and putting it into their consumer apps that we saw here. There's some really nice demos around using NotebookLM. I think I'll actually make a separate video about NotebookLM. I spoke to the key people behind the project. And one of the reasons I haven't made videos in the past is it's been the US only kind of thing. They are planning on making it international. So I will make a video about that and just talk about some of the interesting things you can do with it. And also some of the things that we could look at as that this is a product of just building a RAG system and how they're thinking about now going using both RAG and using the really long context windows in here as we look at this. So just to finish up, I would say that there's a lot of interesting things going on with Gemini. Google does seem to be taking a different approach than, say, OpenAI and stuff like that, that they're doing a lot more incremental updates. So like yesterday, we saw a new version of Gemini 1.5 Pro without changing the name. I think that's probably a corporate thing, but they are actually updating the model and stuff like that. So if you haven't had a play with Gemini 1.5 Pro recently, definitely go and have a look at what you can do with it and then start to think about like now using the Pro versus the Flash model and what are some of the uses for this. Like I said, I will make another video just about the Flash model and we'll look at doing some stuff with code for it as well. Anyway, as always, if you've got comments or questions, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video.